How do you deal when you're stressed? How do you cope with the stress? How do you actually recognize that you have been stressed? And tell us some situations where you have been stressed and how you have recognized and deal with those situations. These types of questions will definitely come up during your recruitment process, during your open day, assessment day, or your final interview. And the recruiters have a very important reason why they do ask you all these questions. We all know that the cabin crew role, besides flying and going to other destinations, dealing with people from all over the world, as a cabin crew, as highly culturally intelligent and emotionally intelligent cabin crew, it is also important that we present ourselves as candidates who also know something about stress management. We have our own stress management techniques when it comes to these situations, because we are going to be working in a job that has a lot of level of stress, starting from preparations itself, since thinking of becoming a cabin crew, and later on reaching to the stage when you will actually become a cabin crew. Ladies and gentlemen, believe it or not, your stress doesn't end up there. It will be continuing towards your flying career. But don't worry, in this video you're gonna hear and see so many interesting suggestions how to answer this question. You're gonna first of all realize why the recruiters are asking you this question. And last but not the least, all I want to say is go on the link below this video from theflyengineer.com, where you have also brilliant ideas how to answer this question. And I do believe that all the blogs that are going hand in hand with the questions that we are answering over here on my Instagram account are a great asset for you to prepare that outstanding answer and to be that outstanding candidate that when the recruiter team will see you, will say, you know what, I actually need this person in my cabin crew team. Stay tuned until the last minute of this video, and don't forget that you should be subscribed over here on my YouTube channel and click the notification button for the many videos that are coming out. Conducting so many duties and responsibilities on board the aircraft as a cabin crew, we are going under so much of stress, and showing an ability that we know how to deal with stress, with stressful situations, recognizing that we are under stress, first of all, coping with that stress, it is serious parameter that you are going to be a serious candidate for the job role called cabin crew. And not knowing how to implement the proper stress management technique in those kind of situations actually is something that can jeopardize the entire safety of the aircraft. In fact, in the past has been proven that the cabin crew and the pilots have been one of the reasons for so many safety scenarios that have been happening on board the aircraft, and with the simple reason preventing those things from happening and ensuring that the safety on board the aircraft is at the highest level always. The recruitment team have a huge responsibility when recruiting candidates, including you watching this video, to know that you will be a candidate who knows about stress management technique. You are actually, just like me, somebody who is undergoing stress every single day of our lives. And believe it or not, sometimes, not sometimes, but most of the time, we are all implementing our own stress management techniques that we are not aware of. So thinking about how was your previous day, what were the things and duties that you did, how you were overloaded with duties and responsibilities. What did you do with all those duties? Did you finish them at that particular time? Did you leave something for tomorrow? Were you prioritizing? How were you dealing with loads of things in your mind, in your hands? That is basically what the recruiters want to know when they will be asking you about stress. How do you deal with the stress? How do you recognize? How do you cope? And please tell us any situation in which you have undergone through a stress and how you deal with it. Experts out there say that the reasons to be stressed as a cabin crew or as a pilot can be physical, physiological, or psychological. The physical stress comes out from the temperature in the aircraft, from the noise, from the humidity, from the oxygen level. So we all would agree that the cabin crew and the pilots are actually stressed at all points of time in the aircraft, because we are having the low or high temperature experiencing all the time during our job as a cabin crew. We are all the time in a, actually I wouldn't say lack of oxygen, but we are in a pressurized cabin where oxygen is not the same as we are on the ground. And all that physical stress is constantly being present. And actually, as a cabin crew, as pilots, we're actually managing this stress on a daily basis. Now, the physiological stress comes up when we are fatigued, when we are hungry, or we have any physical disorder, perhaps. So this is also something that as cabin crew and as pilots, we are managing. Also, as normal human beings like that are not working in the aircraft, we are also managing when we are hungry, we eat, when we want to sleep, we sleep. But if we ignore all those needs and we don't eat, then definitely we can fall up into the category of getting physical stress. So whenever you will be answering questions in front of the recruitment team related to physiological stress, such as when you're stressed and you haven't been eaten, what do you do? Well, I get a bar, muesli bar or something I have right next to me, and I make sure I grab something at that moment, so later on I won't feel more stressed without food. So it's very important that you are actually identifying at a particular moment, how do you feel? You feel stressed, you feel nervous, you haven't eaten anything. What do you do at that particular time? And if you're a cabin crew on board the aircraft and let's say you're hungry, you do not have time to eat, how do you deal with the stress of being hungry? You're in a physiological stress because you are hungry. What do? You just grab a chocolate bar to ensure that your energy level goes a little bit up. You drink some water and you carry on to ensure that the service is going to be done. This is the same technique that you might be applying if you're working in a restaurant, you're working at the reception. But if you show up an example to the recruitment team that whenever you're in a stressful situation due to being hungry and you have been under the category of having physiological stress, then definitely this is something that will be appreciated because you have not ignored it, you've coped with it, and the most important is that you've reached to the final goal that your service was also a priority for you in your job. And a psychological stress, the third category that the experts are talking out there, which is stress caused by certain emotional factors, perhaps a loss of a loved one, a poor interpersonal relationship with family members, worries about your job, something that has happened on your previous flight or your previous day at work and stuff like that. And this all can contribute towards being more stressful. And ladies and gentlemen, all I'm trying to tell you over here is that we are all stressed in our own lives, even if we are not employed in the airline, in the aviation industry, every job in the world, and I don't believe that there is a simple job in the world because every job has its own unique nature and every job has its own unique stress that we as human beings are undergoing through. We have been stressful from school itself, we are stressed at home when we come back and we have to do lots of homework, we are stressed when you have to go to university, the level of stress we have when we're passing exams in university at that particular time is something unbelievable for us. But see, from this perspective, as a graduated student, when you look back to that stress, you're saying, come on, I was stressing for nothing. That is so easy. I would do anything to be a student again, so on and so forth. But we're speaking about that from this point of view now because we have experience and we have learned how to deal with that stress. And we know that if we're in the same situation, we're actually going to be able to undergo that. So this is basically, as I have spoken, one of the situations and the examples that I have given you in the future career as a cabin crew that you will undergo through. You will be stressful just like you are now, perhaps less, but I'm sorry to say this, but I don't think that you will be stressed. From my experience, speaking from my experience, the cabin crew job itself is a stressful job. But don't worry, once you know the techniques how to deal with the stress, and once you know what to answer to the recruitment team about the stress management or how to cope and how to how to first of all realize that you have been stressed, will actually secure you the job at 40,000 feet. What do you say to the recruiters when they ask you and when talk about stress? Take an example from your daily life when you have been overloaded with duties and responsibilities and you felt stressed. How were you dealing with that? I always say this as a perfect example because it will show to the recruiters that tomorrow when you will be going under the same circumstances and under similar situations on board the aircraft, you are a promising person or a promising candidate who knows what to do. So let's say I've been overloaded with lots of works yesterday. I have been having lots of people to be checking in at my counter when I was working as a check-in agent at the airport. So what I did at that particular moment is I checked are my other available resources around me, such as perhaps some of my colleagues have less passengers for checking in and I asked for help. I was able to delegate duties. Ladies and gentlemen, the recruiters want to know, are you able to think resourcefully when you are under stress? The recruiters want to know that you are somebody who knows that you're not alone on board the aircraft. On board the aircraft, you've gotten your colleagues. You can always ask for help. You can always ask for assistance, but that doesn't mean that you should give the job to them. So you are actually showing to the recruiters that you are prioritizing. At that particular moment, when you were working at the check-in counter, your priority to ensure that people are spending less time waiting to check in. So you've checked for the other available resources. So you have been thinking resourcefully. You have been using thinking resourcefully, as I have said, but you also have been prioritizing your resource for your other colleagues at that point, and your priority was passengers spending less time, as I have said, waiting for checking. You can use lots of similar examples like this, where your priority was the customer satisfaction, and when you were thinking that you have other resources available. Last but not the least, when you're overloaded with lots of duties and responsibilities during the day, show to the recruitment team that you have done in that day what was the priority for you for that day, and things that could have been left for tomorrow, you've dealt with those things. When it comes to your personal life stress, show to the recruitment team that when you are at work and when you are professional and you are doing your duties and responsibilities, you're somebody who's totally focused on that. You are so happy when your work time is finished to go back home and to be with your family and to deal with the things that you have been dealing with or you are undergoing with. But you should be able to say that you are actually somebody who's distinguishing all those things. Your personal life is over here, your professional life is over here. You do not allow your personal life to affect your professional life. Last but not the least, display to the recruitment team that you possess a certain knowledge about aviation, about flying, and about the cabin crew job by saying, I do understand that as a passenger, perhaps you have not been working as a cabin crew, but if you have been working as a cabin crew, this is also an excellent example to connect it with your previous experience. But if you have not been a cabin crew, you can always say that from a passenger point of view, when I'm a passenger on board the aircraft, I do understand that number one priority of every airline is the safe and pleasant journey for the passengers, for us, and therefore I do believe that being able to prioritize, we are going to know how to cope with the stress. I do know that being able to think resourcefully and think that always safety comes first, we're going to be more focused on performing our duties and responsibilities as a cabin crew. And take an example that you have read on that example on the internet and you find that example as an outstanding, or connect that as you were observing that something was happening on board the aircraft. Let's say the crew was doing the service, it was a normal flight, you were a passenger, and all of a sudden another passenger felt bad, and you were able to see that the crew immediately secured her card, she took the card to the galley, she ensured that the card is secured, and she went there to assist the passenger, and she politely apologized to the other passengers that she wants to leave, as she wants to help the passenger as she was going through the aisle. So even if you have not been a cabin crew, you're actually somebody who has observed that that crew member was under a stressful situation. She should take the card first, secure the card. She went immediately to help the person, and she was somebody who was able to think to have a priority. Her priority was to help the passenger, to administer first aid, but also her priority was the safety of the other passengers. And last but not the least, you saw that crew member asking for help from the other crew members. So you were able to picture and see how one stressful situation was successfully managed. If you're able to answer a question like this in front of the recruitment team, I'm very sure, and I can assure you that actually you're a serious candidate for the job role called cabin crew. Last but not the least, do not be afraid to display in front of the recruitment team that you have been under stress, because that's not the answer they're looking for. The recruitment team is not looking for candidates who have not been under stress. The recruitment team is looking for a candidate who has been under stress, who has first of all recognized that at that particular moment I have been stressful, and who has been coping with the stress or knew how to manage with the stress by prioritizing duties, by delegating duties to the other resources, as I have said, thinking resourcefully, by actually managing everything and reaching to the final goal, which in the aircraft, it is safety and security of the passenger, but safety and security is a general term that applies everywhere in all fields of human living. Therefore, if you display in front of the recruitment team a full understanding of this, you're actually, as I have said, a serious candidate for the job role, cabin crew, and you're not somebody who has been weak because you have been under stress. The other way around, you're actually somebody who is very, very strong and knows what to do. And I want to end up this video talking to you about the STAR technique. The link of the blog about the STAR technique is right before the right after the link of the flyengineer.com website or the flyengineer.com blog, where my dear friend Jayshree has spoken about the stress management and has given you an idea how to answer the question itself. So right after that link is the STAR technique. Please have a read on that. It's very powerful. A very useful technique that I'm sure it's going to help you present yourself as that outstanding candidate when the recruitment team will see you, will say, you know what, I actually need this person in my cabin crew team. He or she knows how to deal with the stress. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget, as I have said at the beginning, to click subscribe, to hit that notification button, to follow me on my Instagram account, xcrew over here, for all the lives that we do. Live sessions Monday to Friday at 10 o'clock Central European time, 10 o'clock a.m. Central European time, and 1:30 p.m. Indian subcontinent time. We talk about different subjects. Today's week, we are talking about the emotional intelligence and everything that a candidate should know and display regarding the emotional intelligence, and so many topics are coming. We're talking on a daily basis. Make sure to follow my Instagram account, as I have said, and I'm gonna be seeing you very soon. Bye bye and have a nice day.